Hello, this is Tim. Today we will talk about the dynamic stability of an aircraft. First, let's see what is stability. Stability refers to the response of an aircraft after it is subject to a disturbance. Stability can be classified as static stability and dynamic stability. I have already discussed about static stability in my previous video, Understanding Aircraft Stability. So, in this video, I'll be discussing about dynamic stability. First, let's look at what is dynamic stability. After a disturbance on an aircraft, the aircraft's attitude changes. The initial response of the aircraft is called as static stability. The response of an aircraft over a certain time period is called as dynamic stability. Let's see what this means in more detail. This line represents the original position of the aircraft. If there is a disturbance, the aircraft suffers a deviation due to the disturbance. If the aircraft comes back to its original position after a certain time period, then it is said to have positive dynamic stability. The flight path of this stability will look like this, with the amplitude of oscillations reducing. In case after the disturbance, if the aircraft keeps deviating from its original position after a certain time period, then it is said to have negative dynamic stability. The flight path of this stability will look like this, with the amplitude of the oscillations increasing. After the disturbance, if the aircraft maintains the same oscillation after a certain time period, then it is said to have neutral dynamic stability. The flight path of this stability will look like this, with the amplitude of the oscillations being constant. So the dynamic stability of an aircraft can be divided into positive dynamic stability, negative dynamic stability, and neutral dynamic stability. The aircraft should have positive dynamic stability. Now, let's look at a few cases, starting with longitudinal dynamic stability. This stability is applicable if the aircraft is subject to a disturbance in pitch. The oscillation should be quickly damped and the aircraft should return to its original attitude. But if the oscillations are not quickly damped, then it is called as Phugoid oscillation. In this, as the aircraft's altitude increases, the speed decreases. And as the altitude decreases, the speed increases. So, the potential energy, that is the altitude, and the kinetic energy, that is the velocity, are interchanging. So this can be called as a constant energy oscillation. Now let's look at a few cases related to lateral and directional dynamic stability. We have to combine these two because the roll and yaw are interconnected. This means that if the aircraft yaws towards the right, the left wing will move faster than the right wing. So more lift is created on this wing, hence the aircraft will automatically roll towards the right. In a similar case, if the aircraft rolls towards the left, the lift vector gets tilted towards the left. So the aircraft will automatically yaw towards the left. One of the cases related to lateral and directional dynamic stability is spiral instability. This occurs if the aircraft has positive directional stability, but not enough lateral stability. The flight path after a lateral disturbance will look like this. In this instability, the bank angle increases, the altitude decreases, and the turn becomes tighter. Another case related to lateral and directional dynamic stability is the Dutch roll. This occurs if the aircraft has positive lateral stability, but not enough directional stability. The Dutch roll is a combination of roll and yaw. After the disturbance, the aircraft will try to come back to its original position. But since the directional stability is not sufficient, it will oscillate about its original flight path. In order to avoid cases like Phugoid oscillation, spiral instability, and Dutch roll, the aircraft should have positive dynamic stability. So let's look at how to improve the positive dynamic stability. First, the aircraft should have positive static stability. For static stability, the center of pressure, Cp, should be behind the center of gravity, Cg. The wing design can be modified into a swept back wing and giving a small dihedral or anhedral angle. A proper tail section design, which means a good design of the horizontal and the vertical stabilizers. After the disturbance, positive inputs by the pilot or the autopilot to dampen the oscillations with the help of control surfaces such as elevators, rudder, and ailerons will improve the positive dynamic stability. Thank you for watching and please subscribe.